Can I follow, keep it in? No, Brat. Good job to get body position. Can he win the battle? Yes, he does. And now the Devils have possession. Ty Smith behind the back to himself. Nifty play. Excellent pressure by Deneau. In front. Iafallo wins it! Alex Iafallo for what should be the number one star in the game. Philip Deneau earning that big cash he got in the offseason. He gets the takeaway. He makes the tape-to-tape dime to Iafallo, who makes no mistake, and it's the Kings who get the extra point.
An unbelievable play by Deneau. First of all, he gets control of the puck behind the net as Ty Smith is trying to hold it, keep control of the puck. Instead of chipping it along the boards, he thinks he can get away from Deneau, but Deneau steals it. You mentioned, Butch, this is on the tape, and Iafallo gets to walk into the forward tees and hammer this past Mackenzie Blackwood. 5 goals on the year for Iafallo. Todd McClellan was saying this guy could be a 25-goal scorer. Well, he's got 5 in the bag already, and the Kings get a 3-2 overtime win.
He might get 35. He's on that kind of pace.
Yeah, I told you he wanted to shoot more. He didn't. And Iafallo talks so highly of Deneau, saying he always knows where he is, very supportive, loves playing with him. What an addition.
If you walk away, walk away, walk away, walk away, Iafallo.
Three stars time now here in Los Angeles. Deneau, you'd think, would have to be one.
I think Iafallo's one.
Kempe is the other problem.
All right, let's take a look at tonight's three stars of the game, brought to you by New Amsterdam Vodka. As it's the Kings who get the extra point. And it was a tough start to this game, trying to manufacture some excitement for you ESPN Plus subscribers, and we appreciate you King fans and Devil fans.
It looked like the Kings had the game with the, on the Kaliev power play goal, but Pavel Zacha sends it to overtime, so the Devils grind out a point on the road.
Cal Peterson will be the third star, the goaltender. He was good enough, right?
He was. He made a mess of things a little bit in the first period. He had to bail himself out with some loose pucks, but started to settle in. I thought he played really well tonight.
He made that great save at the end of regulation.
That's right. Off Jimmy Vesey. That can get, help him get to the overtime and get the extra point. But here's the second star. Matt Roy, solid game on the back end, the right-hand shooting defenseman.
Boy, were we off.
More responsibility keeps falling onto Matt Roy's plate with the injuries to Sean Walker and Drew Doughty, and plays a quiet game, moves the puck pretty simply.
I imagine Iafallo, the winner, will probably be number one, which... There he is. Minnesota Duluth Bulldog. Remember, the Kings started 1-5-1. They've won 4 in a row, and Alex Iafallo is turning into a really good pro. He's in the prime of his life. He's in his late 20s, a college player, late bloomer.
Stronger.
Yep.
More confident. You see him when he skates, like there's a purpose to where he's headed. Looked terrific tonight. You can see why Todd McClellan's so excited about him.
Yeah, he was at the Frozen Four. Todd McClellan's son, Tyson, won a national championship at Denver. Iafallo was at that Frozen Four in Chicago. His team didn't win Minnesota Duluth. Then he left, turned pro, and then Minnesota Duluth won 2 national championships in a row. He just missed it. But he was in that Frozen Four in Chicago. We did a segment with various players in each team, went out and got some deep dish pizza, had them rate it. And he was one of the fellows who sat down with me and had some deep dish pizza in Chicago at that Frozen Four. And tonight, he has really shown that he is turning into a professional hockey player, as his goal is the winning goal for the Los Angeles Kings, and he is the number one star. Jim Morrison in the Doors cranks out here in the Staples Center. Alex Iafallo now walking back out. He's going to talk with our Linda Cohn. He's walking on the Kings bench. He'll come over and put a headset on, and Linda will lean over. Come on the ice, Alex. Here, he's going to put a headset on. There he is. From Deneau, tape to tape, winner, winner, chicken parm dinner, and he is down there with Linda Cohn. Linda.
Alex, Yes, congratulations. What a game. What a finish. We talked earlier today. You told me you're working on your shooting. You're shooting from everywhere. You definitely shot more, and you shot at the right time here to win it.
Yeah, it was good timing. Philly made a great play. I just had to put it in, to be honest.
I'm telling you, we talked about Philip Deneau and what he's meant to this team and what he's meant to you. What makes him so great? Why are you guys click?
He's unbelievable getting pucks. You could see it the last play, but in each zone, you know, defensive, middle, and offensive, he's always getting the puck and always finding ways to, you know, get open.
That's four straight wins now for you guys. Big picture, what's going so right?
Just get the puck, shoot it, and get it back. That's where that's our mindset, and you know, keeping things simple, getting good breakouts, and playing offense. That's what we do, and we're gonna have fun doing it.
Great resilience, great win. Congratulations on a great victory.
Thank you, appreciate it.
Got it.
Have a good one,
gentlemen.
All right, Linda, Alex Iafallo. Man, he made no mistake. It's one thing to get that pass in the slot, but he absolutely wired it like it was 2 o'clock in the afternoon doing a shooting drill.
Yeah, he was not gonna waste any time to corral it to try and make the perfect shot. He just powdered it.
Yeah.
Past Peterson, and the Kings win in overtime.
Tee it high, let it fly, gungala gungala, nothing but net. It's the Kings who get the extra point. The Devils scrap to get one of their own. Good night from LA, y'all.